Eat-Gary secrets from my house to help you live longer and stay healthy. Stress is the number one major ager of your body. That's why it's so important for me to decompress after a long day. Same for you. Here's what I do to fight stress at home. If the weather's nice, I like to hang outside for about 15 minutes. I can pat Rosie and I get to lie in my hammock just sort of begin de-stressing from the day. Come on over here, Rosie. Oh, there you are. Patting Rosie is a great de-stressor. Another way that I love to de-stress at the end of the day is using certain special yoga poses. Child's pose is my favorite to start with. Get on your knees, relax your thighs, your hips, and then lean forward. Bring your arms to your side. As you do that, all the tension in your lower back, your shoulders, your neck, it all passes into the ground. And meditation is how I ultimately get ready for sleep. Tensions and the thoughts and the stresses of the day pass. And now that I'm fully distressed from my day, it's time to say goodnight and goodbye to you.
When I get stressed out, guys, I'm always stressed because I'm a single mom and I always double book myself.
Yeah.
And sometimes I just feel like, what am I going to do? And so I come home, take a bubble bath, and what I get tea. I get jasmine tea and just go.
That's good. Yeah. Getting any kind of routine is wonderful. That's what I was just showing there. I mean, it's not the perfect routine for everybody, but it works for me. So I'm going to walk you through a couple things that work in my life. They might be helpful, too, and a lot of folks watching.
Good, good.
Right? Now, your bedroom ought to be a calming place for you to escape. That's why it's important to choreograph this smartly. Now, my bedroom happens to smell like a pizza parlor half the time because the kids are always getting oregano on their chest for chest colds and the guy garlic. So all those smells come together. But there's some other smells we actually want to have in the bedroom. We keep them there. We have a lot of lavender and cinnamon and rosemary. It happens to be that those are scents that really are effective at de-stressing us. So I like the idea of mixing together these different things. The lavender, some cinnamon, some rosemary, and you put it into a clean sock, not a dirty one, clean sock.
Okay.
Tie the top up here, and this becomes like a squeeze ball. Right?
Wow.
Plus, it works like a potpourri, right? It's got a scent to it. Smell that. So you can leave a sash on your bed. You can put it in a drawer with some clothes that you have to get them to smell like that as well. You know, it's inexpensive to make, and I think very effective. That's tip number one. That's yours.
Okay.
A pleasure to you. All right, so when you go to bed, it's of course ultimately when we review ourselves. What do you wear? What kind of pajamas do you wear? Pajamas?
I wear cotton pajamas. I like loosey stuff because I don't like feeling like, ugh, tighten up. So I wear loosey. Like sometimes I wear t-shirts. And
do you always wear something?
Always. Because
okay.
I'd be thinking about maybe a finer or something.
Just in case.
Just in case.
What an optimist you are. All right. So I usually just wear a t-shirt.
Okay.
A big, extra large, beaten up old t-shirt. You know, like a lot of you, I probably have a couple of friends that are really favorites of mine. I enjoy cotton as well, but I want them really bulky. I want the room really cool. But I know for a lot of folks, they either don't like that feel on you or you really have problems with heat, which is a real reason people can't sleep at night. They get too hot. So I just found out about these products. I took one home recently, actually. But just try these things out. Just take a feel. I'll give it to you in a second.
Oh, goodness. I like this.
Doesn't it feel good?
Oh, yeah.
So these things are called Good Nighties. They're high-performance sleepwear. They have a fabric that wicks away moisture, so it keeps you really cool all night long.
Oh, really? Okay.
I like the way they feel, actually, on it. So you can put these kinds of things on if you're ready to get out of the fire. I wonder if they're fire-resistant. Might be helpful checking it out.
I wonder, because I'm going to check these out because I really want some of these.
You think they're switching to these?
Oh, I would buy some of these.
These are yours. These are yours. And the color goes with your eyes. Now, the next secret is one that you could all imitate almost immediately.
Okay.
At the end of the day, one of the best ways to de-stress and to fight off that stress in an effective way is physical contact. And I've got this little tip that might be valuable to you. This is orange-infused coconut oil.
Okay,
so you take a coconut oil, and then put a rind of a lemon in there, or an orange, okay?
Okay.
And the orange is very soothing anyway. And after you squirt, you know, keep it there for about, you know, 10, 12 hours just to let it purely infuse, put a few drops in your finger. Yeah, I'll put some for you too.
Okay.
I'll do yours actually.
Okay.
Right, and then, if you got a partner, they can do it for you, or you do it yourself. Get to the temples, which is where so many of the stress.
I get stress headaches.
You do?
I mean, lots of times. I get a lot of headaches.
You better get one of those kids or a man in your life or someone to do this for you. All right. You massage the temple area. The orange has.
Oh, that feels good, dog. Oh, my goodness. Can I take you home?
I'll come home with you.
Okay.
With the orange lowers the stress hormone, the coconut oil will be stressed, and you will guide us. solution.
Wow, thank you so much, Dr. Ayers.
Thank you, Dr. Honor is mine. Next up, I'm taking you to one of my most sacred places where cameras have never been allowed to sit down. And coming up on Monday, spark your metabolism.